Hey guys, Tough Thumbs here. So, any Emerson fans, you might want to turn away right now, because this is going to be the sexiest Emersons you've ever seen in your life. Seriously. Yeah, just a sample here of what's going on. Got that and a few other things, and a really sweet Hinder, and just some news. Basically got myself an anodizing kit, kind of like you would see Modifieds use. And I like want to shout out Modifieds again. If you guys didn't sub him, make sure you sub him. He helped me out a lot. I'm more of a visual learner. When it came to this whole anodizing thing, I mean, there's like pages and there's like booklets and shit. I mean, it's just ridiculous. I mean, it's too much for me to take in. Measuring and all that stuff, I'm kind of dumb when it comes to that stuff. So, yeah, I just want to thank Modifieds a lot. And you guys, check him out. He makes some really nice stuff. And, And also today I got a package from Gamer Dude, who is the best person ever in the history of YouTube, and I'm kidding. Nah, he's a friend, he's a good dude, and he made this pen for me. It's really nice. It's some kind of Jack Daniels something wood, but it's really nice. Well, thanks, dude. Appreciate it. I'm sure I'll beat the shit out of you in Black Ops tonight, so. Very nice, man. Like, nice craftsmanship. He's not like taking orders for these or anything like that. I don't know. Nice, good job. Nice gift from somebody. I appreciate it. Definitely cool. Guys, I'm gonna do a video on the Southern Flipper in a little while because you find your perfect knife and it kind of, comes out of nowhere. And I haven't touched a single thing in my collection except this since I got it. I'll talk about it later. It's been through its paces and it's holding up well, so definitely recommend it. So anyway, guys, you see these karambits here. This is all one guy's order. I had trouble getting silver twill. Silver twill seemed to have disappeared for a little bit. I finally got some. It took forever to get it. And, it's my dumbass fault for not looking hard enough, but I did look a lot of places and just couldn't find it. But I finally did. So I'm completing this, and guys, there's a lot of things that you don't want to see that I do, because it's the same thing over and over, and that, you'll kind of get that from this video here. Now, you guys have seen these before. You got the C-Tech blue, C-Tech red, karambit. You got the pink karambit, and these are just the three that need to be finished. You got the pink Persian. Looks nice. I mean, definitely can't deny that. I do like pink, but, I'm not going to say that out loud. Oop, just did, actually. But, it's unfortunately the anodizing kit guy, or the anodizing machine. The pink looks awesome. It's like probably the brightest, most vibrant color you can get out of there, and it looks crazy, but, I doubt I'm ever going to get to use it, so. Any guys who are willing to do pink on a knife, that'd be pretty cool to get your something anodized with it. But anyway, first up, got a mini commander, part of this order as well. This one is pink G10. Smooth. The screws and everything will be polished. Same with the pocket clip. That's what all of them will be. Not a smooth knife at all. I mean, this one's not finished because I just threw it together. It still needs to be taken down around the edges a little bit, which also cleans up the water jet marks. As you can see, it's not completely flush. I just want to show in the video. It's pretty much done though. Just a couple minutes. Anonymous came over here and hijacked my grinder, so I do everything on the grinder so it's more even. Yeah. Pink Emerson Mini Commander. And then you got a Emerson Bullnose Karambit. Same deal. Pink G10. Looking very pretty. Very vicious. See, these are comfortable though. With that, nice contoured scales. They're very comfortable. So I'm not a huge fan of these, but I do what they say. This is basically for a female self-defense class. They all basically are getting these, so that's why. Not to put down women and say they only like pink. I know a lot of women are touchy about that, especially my girlfriend or my fiance, excuse me. All right, so next up, another karambit. This one I actually like a lot. It's actually kind of cool. I don't really love silver twill, but sometimes it just like works, I guess. And this one just looks real clean. So, I do think it's cool, actually. So you get on another Karambit Emerson. Nice satin blade, which I prefer a lot over the black blade. And it's got silver twill. It's contoured around the edges. This twill I got is, I don't like it as much as the stuff I got from Alpha Knife Supply. The quality just doesn't seem to be there, but it was a nicer finish on there. So I decided instead of contouring it, which would have looked like crap because it's thin, I just left the shiny coating. I think that's what they wanted anyway. But again, extremely comfortable. Just a little bit of thickness and contouring in the right spots. Feels really good. And this is what they look like finished. See, the liners are all nice and even, perfectly flush. Everything just perfect on there. I like this one, it's cool. Unfortunately, I gotta change the hardware to satin, which I think will kind of take away from the look of it. But it's a nice one. Silver twill is pretty cool. I mean, it's a flashy knife. I mean, you want to whip this thing out and get some attention. I mean, it's for self-defense, so you know, this will basically confuse anybody you pull it out on. It's pretty cool, though. And yeah, guys, I mean, I hate not making videos. I mean, I said it before, and then it got even worse. I mean, the other day, today, I spent most of the day getting that anodizing machine working because I'm an idiot. Multiples and shipping, so not much happened even to show, which annoyed me, but I'm catching up on stuff that's you know, just grunt work, so I'll be having a lot more stuff to show, and I've done some things around the shop to make things go smoother, so, I mean, these are all one day, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, can I count? That's 2, 3, 4, 5, yeah. Yeah, so that's not, you know, it's how it used to be. I got more done. And unfortunately, they're all the same, but you know, this one is my favorite out of these Emersons today. Still got no damn music on my phone. But anyway. Alright, so I'm trying to make the Karambit spiral here. I have about 10 more of these. So next up, one of my favorite Emersons for sure. It's one I don't hear much about. Doesn't get a lot of attention, and arguably probably like one of the more useful ones. CQC 10. Beautiful grind. Love this one. It's a nice drop point. I just love this one. I mean, with the hole and everything, just sick. And even with this silver twill here, looks damn good. Again, none of these are completely finished. See, it's off center. I don't know if it's not tight or there's something wrong with the pivot there. It's just stuff I check afterwards. I threw these together without any proofreading beforehand, but it doesn't smooth into rock or anything like that. It's probably just something as simple as tightening the pivot a little bit. So, I just did not want to get too late before I put this video up, guys, so just occasionally I don't fix everything completely perfect before the video. This is nice. Again, super comfy. This one's got an awesome grip. Slightly different than some other Emersons. I like it a lot. Now, Silver 12, guys, I don't recommend it unless you're looking for something just flashy. It's not very strong. It's kind of weird. I don't know. It's more of a looks thing than anything else. There's no strength to it. It's just woven aluminum with the same epoxy used, or resin used in G10. So it basically falls into the G10 category. Some people are confused about that. Silver G10, some people call it. I don't know. Some people call it silver carbon fiber, which it's not. So, now finally, this one's more along my speed. This is for Hand Hands, my buddy. the first time I've used the anodizing machine, didn't do anything crazy because didn't want to push it for the first time. So I did something just nice and classy, and basically went with blue. But it's a nicer blue than I've ever gotten before. So I always wanted to have a dark navy blue G10 or be able to get titanium dark blue, but never have been able to. So first up, your XM 18 3.5 inch, 20 CV, awesome knife. If you guys watch Gavco's video, he's talking about how these things grow on you. Oh yes, they do. They grow on you. I mean, I don't know what it is, but I've seen a million of these things, but they're just, I get this one in the mail, same old crap, and I'm just like, that's a nice hinder. You know, like, what the hell's wrong with me? They are nice, I tell ya. So this one has the extremely hard sandblasted carbon fiber. There's a lot of texture on here. You can see there. It's very aggressive. It doesn't hurt your hands or anything like that, but I'm getting a good shot here. Oh, lighting. There you go. So you see that texture is pretty wicked, but it's not, it doesn't hurt your hands or anything like that. It doesn't dig in or anything. So you get carbon fiber. Then you can see the liner is a dark blue, along with the clip and the spacer thingy. But that blue is just nothing I've ever gotten before. It's gorgeous. I love the way this looks. I wish the standoffs were titanium, but they're not. I had watched Modified's video about the how to multi-etch, and I was pretty disappointed when he was trying to do it and nothing happened. So, I mean, it just kind of completes the look. It doesn't look bad like this, but it'd be great to be able to get like these three dots blue. I mean, I could do it with heat, but it won't turn out the same. It might look weird, but this looks very clean like this. Very nice. That is an awesome blue, seriously. Smooth as hell. I love that liner being blue in there with the carbon fiber next to it. It looks gorgeous. And the other one I had, the one I had that was blue, was a little brighter blue, so it was a little more in your face. This is more like subdued, like darker, like less bright. Just awesome. So clean too. I mean, you don't take away the stonewash at all. I mean, definitely learning curve with that machine, but guys, I'll do a video on it probably. I'm not going to do a whole crazy thing. I mean, there's plenty of videos of people showing it. I'm sure you don't, but I have some ideas that I know nobody's ever done before, and you guys know me. I like to use stuff the wrong way, so I got some crazy shit that I'm going to do. I guess all sorts of ideas are popping out of my head with this stuff, so I just got to make sure I don't get too sucked into it to the point where I don't get anything done. That tends to happen sometimes when I get new toys. Yep, so hands. Let me know what you think of that, bro. Alright, guys, thanks for watching. Have a great night. Peace.